Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
Someone's been stabbed. He's about 14.
Oh my God, it's just collapsed.
Across the UK, more than 14 million 999 calls are made for an ambulance a year, with the North West Ambulance Service receiving a new cry for help every 20 seconds.
She just thinks she's pregnant or didn't know, but she said she feels like she needs to push.
As the pressure builds...
There's absolutely no reason to talk to me like that. I'm trying to help you here.
The control room has to decide who will receive an ambulance...
17-year-old male, cardiac arrest.
..and who must wait.
We do have delays at the moment of up to 8 hours and 45 minutes.
No.
On the ground, ambulance crews race to save lives.
It's been a serious road accident. All five are in a serious condition.
And offer the best help they can.
Oh, it's been nice of you to come here. Well, it was so nice to talk to.
Tell you what, Norman, you're made of strong stuff.
Black pudding.
Black pudding. Black pudding. I love a bit of black pudding.
From the picket line...
Everyone's going on strike because no one can afford to live.
..to the front line...
Are you going to be violent towards our crew?
This is the story of some of the darkest days in the history of our NHS.
He was quite happy to die on the streets of Manchester.
It's going to probably get a little bit worse... ..before it gets better.
3276, unexploded bomb.
To my hometown! Beats Darwin.
Nothing beats Darwin.
With the latest BBC News for Greater Manchester, I'm Michelle Adamson. Junior doctors in Greater Manchester are striking for a third day today. Hundreds of hospital appointments and non-urgent operations have been cancelled in our region since the walkout began on Tuesday morning.
Morning.
It's Thursday and the start of a new 12-hour shift for the North West Ambulance Service.
I don't know what it's going to be like with the junior doctors on strike.
From reading about it in the news and stuff like that, they make up a ridiculous amount of the workforce. And I know all the surgeries and everything are being kept out.
Dispatchers Jamie and JP are looking after the 41 ambulance crews working across South Manchester today.
Good morning.
Morning, darling.
Including Alpha 196, Jess and Abby.
Did you sleep all right?
I did, but I had to put, like, me, like, not the rain music on. Because it's been so rainy.
It makes me need to go to the toilet when I put that on.
Right, cog.
And Mandy and Sam in Alpha 097.
Good morning, radio check.
Very good morning. I do believe the junior doctors are on strike, which is going to make A&E an interesting picture.
It seems to be affecting us in terms of call volume. I've not seen it this low since COVID. Yeah. Hopefully, people are only calling when it's absolutely necessary.
This is North West Ambulance Service.
Hello.
I'm just going to ask you some questions so we can get some help arranged for you, OK?
The ambulance coming around here now with the sirens going. I'm naked.
Right, OK. Do you think you would be able to put some clothes on when they arrive?
On shift today are 57 call handlers, answering calls across the northwest.
Hi, love. I'm sorry to bother you. I just woke up, just had me breakfast and everything. One of my testicles has sort of got a hole in it.
We're at hospital. These query sepsis, but we don't have any doctors on hand or anything.
Danny, you're looking to get transferred to another hospital, are you?
Yeah, we need to get to the hospital as soon as possible.
Well, he's just had a car accident.
Right, OK. So is the patient breathing?
He can't get out of the car, but yes, he's breathing. He's bleeding. He looks like he's broke his leg.
What's the address of the emergency, please?
Junction 17, M60.
353, come on in, it's Matt and Trauma Cell. Just to let you know, you've been allocated to this RTC. We've got a second ambulance backing you up, so there's some potential for major trauma injuries, but I've not had a clinical update as of yet.
No problem, thanks very much. I'll give you an update when I get to see you.
QX353 senior paramedic Aidan is immediately dispatched to the patient. He is 8 minutes away.
Oh, my goodness. What's happened, buddy?
I don't remember why, but I lost control of the car.
Okay.
And
and I tried to get on the tire, but it's definitely broken.
I can see your leg there, buddy. All right, you'd stay nice and still. Any pain at the back of your neck? No pins and needles in the back of your head, neck?
No.
Okay, just lift this arm, relax this arm for me. Hi, okay. This is Luke. He's hit this barrier. He's got quite an obvious mid-shaft femur with the looks of it. We'll try and manage, get IV access, and then we'll need a Kendrick splint. So, at the minute, Luke, I can see that this right leg of yours has got quite a nasty break. All right, buddy. So, we're going to put a little needle into your arm, give you some strong pain relief, and see if we can get you out safely onto a board. Is that OK? Thanks, mate. Just an early update from scene. He's got quite a nasty mid-shaft femur fracture to the right leg. We might need something stronger than morphine. So it's just an early update, see if anyone's local, that's all.
I think we've got three QXs in Manchester today, so I will have a little look for you. And just let us know whether you think he's been major trauma or not, but we'll get a QX for you.
Matt and Sarah are dispatchers in the complex incident hub. They are responsible for dispatching rapid response vehicles to the most critically ill patients.
I need to put on loudspeaker, I haven't got enough hands, sorry. John's 10 away. I'm gonna run him.
Okay, nice and still for me.
Nice and relaxed for us.
353.
Thank you. Could you ask fire service to attend this job, please? In terms of extricating, it's going to be quite difficult with this fracture.
353, obviously, you know, down to the hero.
Can you just tell me how long you want to be in hospital for?
It's up to the surgical team, because you'll definitely probably need surgery on this leg.
Hello.
Hi, OK. There's quite a significant intrusion there.
Probably end up giving him some ketamine and just...
manage it from there. Hello, mate, you OK? So I'm thinking, we manage analgesia, roof off, take him off backwards, and then we can get him on the board. Just quite a lot of noise, buddy, all right?
OK.
Your airbags have not even come out, have they?
No, this car's shit. Yeah.
There you go. Convertible now, pal.
So what I'll do is, before we do anything, I'm going to give you some ketamine. It wears off pretty quickly. The important thing is, when I give it you, think happy thoughts, because you'll have a good dream.
Slide him up on here, and then literally, yeah. You know the full scoop? Just put it over there where there's more room.
It'll keep you busy then. Did you say 7-11?
Okay, happy. 3, 2, 1, traction. Okay. You're right there.
Sticks and stones move out my bones.
Oh my god, so many things just keep going through my head. I'm a United fan.
Are you?
Christian Eriksen. Oh, that shit.
So am I. We'll talk about that on the way.
We can't do anything about you being a United fan, Luke, though.
Yeah, it turns out it'll be a major trauma over to Salford.
That's the receipt, no time to be
okay. That job with John is major trauma. He's on his way to Salford, possible pelvic injury. John is going to travel because he's given him some ketamine.
Sweet.
So you've lost that AP.
I mean, it's fine.
We've still got one more in Manchester, which is good.
I'm going to make my way to Salford, if you don't mind keeping us unavailable, please.
Thanks for the update, and I'll speak to you later.
Due to the strikes, we have seen a reduction in our call volume. The lower acuity patients appear to be calling less. They do not wish to wait longer than they need to. They don't want to drain key emergency services if they absolutely don't have to. Major trauma, cardiac arrest, those patients are still calling 999 and they still will need us.
Is an ambulance required today?
No, Bank of England. Give me my money. Problem, I'm very angry.
No, I know that you're angry, but I'm not able to help with any financial queries that you may have.
Is it financial queries? Yes! And I don't show, I don't have a show.
It's over 4 hours into the shift, and call volume has doubled to 254 calls incoming, with a new call being answered every 14 seconds.
Hello, it's the ambulance service. We've had a call from the police.
Oh, thank God for that.
Do you need an ambulance?
Yeah, but...
The first time I saw Russia put the oldest army down, I thought, God.
Right, sorry to interrupt you there. This is a recorded line and it's an emergency line.
Oh, thank you. Please come to the ambulance, my apologies.
Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
Yeah, she is struggling with her breathing.
Is she breathing now?
I'm not sure. I'm calling from the doctor's surgery. The patient has just called me. She says she needs help. She can't breathe.
Alpha 196, just sending you through a Category 2 call now.
It's come through from a doctor who's advised us that the patient is struggling to breathe.
It's also been mentioned that they've got some chest pain.
Just to the nearest A&E.
The closest crew are Jess and Abby, who are 8 minutes away.
It's always awkward, isn't it? Because chest pain, it can be something or nothing, but it's just not worth the risk.
Well, a lot of chest pains end up going to hospital, don't they?
There's not much more we can do other than, you know, we need blood to do it.
Hiya, Claire. I'm Jess. This is Abby. What's been happening then?
I don't feel well at all.
Okay. So when you say you don't feel well, what in particular do you not feel
under
well
my
with?
Chest,
the chest pain.
It feels like somebody's kicked me in the chest.
Right, okay.
And I wondered if I'd got pleurisy or something.
Are you diagnosed with anything in particular?
I've got cerebral palsy.
Can I have a little listen to your chest?
Yeah, you can.
And while she's doing that, I'm just going to take a little bit above my finger. Is that okay?
Yeah.
At the minute, your oxygen levels are perfect.
But I'm not moving around, you see. It keeps happening.
Hmm.
And I'm getting out of breath.
Okay.
And I'm sort of coughing, and this mucus is coming up.
Think it's probably worth getting a few checks done. It all looks
standard,
good,
yes.
But that's as much as we can do. We can't look any further, so that's why we'll have to take you.
I don't mind.
Is that okay? Do you live here by yourself, I'm guessing?
Yeah. It is difficult.
How long have you been here for?
5 years.
Where were you before then?
Stoke, with my late husband.
Oh,
nice. Because I lost him. Yeah, it's been a bit of a day.
Oh, Christ.
So, yeah.
Oh, what was his name?
Mark.
Have you always struggled with your health then?
I have, yeah. Lots of different things. From, you know, just my disability. I've had you walk alongside me since I was a kid. And
that's what we're here for.
Literally.
That's why we do it.
No, literally. I was born breech prem. I've had you save me from sticky situation after sticky situation. We can't do without them.
Exactly.
We can't, no, we can't.
We can't.
And it can't go private. People like us do not stand a chance if it goes private.
That's what we're trying to fight for with all these strikes.
All I can say to you, they really do need to plough more money into our NHS services.
We could have done with you on the picket line with a little megaphone.
I'd come with you.
We'll invite you along next time, shall we?
Please do. Please do, because I'll tell you now. It ain't me the loudest.
Ready? 3, 2, 1. There we go.
Ready?
A few bumps, keep your rubbers in. Right, are you good to go, Claire?
I am.
Yeah, OK.
Claire will be transferred to the nearest A&E at Withenshaw Hospital.
Junior doctors are on strike.
Yes, I know that.
It might slow down the process of getting seen by a doctor.
Don't bother me, that doesn't.
Doesn't it? You don't mind waiting?
No.
Wow, you're very rare. Someone says they don't mind waiting at the hospital.
When you have spent hours and hours and hours living your life, going from one appointment to another with your mother, you just learn patience.
Yeah.
As a disabled person, you learn patience. That's one thing you learn.
I always say to people, this job is like a daily reality check. When I'm going through things at home, it's nice to go to work and, you know, step away from my life and my worries and focus on them. I think without it, I'd really struggle sometimes with the things that life throws at you. Well, it's been lovely to meet you, Claire, anyway.
Yeah. Yes, and you take care, both of you.
Yeah. We'll take you in, and then we'll hand you over to the nurses, and then they'll look after you then, OK?
Yeah.
A few bumps.
Let's go for a rumble.
And speaking to people and knowing that you're not alone in this life and there's people also going through rough times, and you can bond on that.
people like her, you just kind of realise how much use the NHS is. Like, if she was in, like, the likes of America, where they don't have, like, any sort of free national health...
And imagine the amount of money that would cost. It does make you think how amazing the NHS
is. And how lucky we are, really.
We are so lucky. We really are. My mum had cancer when I was 8. About 5 years ago, she got the all clear. Everything was sorted. And then just yesterday, we were told, you know, it's metastasised to the heart. They've said that they can give her medication just to keep her going for a few years. If the NHS wasn't a thing, then my mum definitely couldn't, you know, she doesn't even get sick pay at work. And I think if we had to pay for the treatment, I think it would change her mind. She would probably let herself, you know, just have this cancer. Three magpies. Four magpies. What's that?
I only know one for sorrow, two for joy, and that's as much as I know. I should know it.
Three for a boy or a girl? Mind if I just FaceTime my mum quick? See how she's doing.
I wonder what you need to know.
How are you?
All right, you?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. You're not feeling too poorly today, then?
No, not too bad at all.
Oh, God.
Can you get some bread on the way home, please?
Go.
Cardiac arrest.
What's the last four of it?
0137.
It's lunchtime and call volume is ramping up in control. There are 25 ongoing Category 1 calls and only one advanced paramedic is available to Matt and Sarah.
35-year-old cardiac arrest.
Where is it?
Where's Luke?
Are we better sending a senior clinical resource anyway?
I'd say send him. He can always leave if we need him to.
How far is he on when we arrest him?
20.
There you go. Decision made.
There's also 0154. Romeo 570 is about to come across it.
Lee, I think for that one, we'll probably hang fire because we've got a lorry versus car RTC not far from Barton. 0154.
Traveling on the M60 and we've just spotted a crash.
And what's the address of the ambulance?
Just before junction 11 on the M60.
Can you see anyone injured at all?
No, we just drove past the man in the driver's seat. His head seems to be a bit slumped.
Is slumped and the car is facing the wrong way round, so there's potential for an unconscious patient. I'll have a chat with Holmes.
Your RTC is now not breathing.
Is it not?
No.
Okay, 353. It's a traumatic cardiac arrest. Patient's not conscious, not breathing, and there is a significant damage. I think the car is underneath or into the side of the lorry.
Alpha 391, HEMS, the heart team, and QX353 senior paramedic Aidan are all sent on the highest category response.
I think you're going to hit the M60 from 12 down to 11, 10 and 9. Heart's going to be coming from 9 up to 10. If you can spot it, even if you haven't hit scene, just let us know the rough location because we still can't get a plot on it.
No worries, mate. I'll make my way towards it and keep us updated.
Sorry, can we just confirm the location of the incident and whether it's actually on the motorway? We're struggling to locate it.
353, thanks. I've just come past the Trafford Centre and I can't see nothing on the opposite carriageway home.
Let me see if I can get on cameras.
Due to the difficulty locating the car crash, multiple dispatchers across the northwest are attempting to find the unconscious patient.
Yeah, I can't see it on the cameras.
So it's a convertible versus a lorry. We've got to be able to find that. We've got an SP, a truck, both HEMS and half of heart.
Is there anything else happening? Because we're sending a lot of resources to this, aren't we? There's still nothing on the cameras, 12 to 9.
Hate jobs on the motorway.
I'm just on scene now with fire.
Right, have you found it?
Yay, I'm on scene. Hello, mate. You okay?
Right. Lorry, hit me on the side there.
Have you got any injuries where you'd like us to check
no
you over?
No physical injuries, I'm just still shaking a bit.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, absolutely, leave it with us, thank you.
353, go ahead.
Thank you. So all resources can stand down, I'll deal on scene. The gentleman is out of the car, he's conscious and I'm breathing. No apparent injuries.
Roger, thank you.
They're all
yeah,
that.
One sec.
Honestly.
And everyone down. 0216, Mersey, you've just rang about. Horses landed on a 43-year-old.
So those resources that we've just...
0239.
..battered across the M60, can we send them to the Wirral now, please?
Also, 0239 stabbed in the bum.
Where we are.
making decisions where we only have one resource to use and there are two instances, that's difficult. The consequences of getting those decisions wrong could be a life or death. It'd be fantastic to have lots and lots of resources, way more than we do have now. But we are losing experienced staff. This is happening because of a lack of investment in the wider NHS. It cannot carry on for too much longer.
Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
Yeah, he's caught his balls.
Is the patient awake?
Yeah, we've swung the van, but we know his balls are hanging off.
Right, how's that happened? How's the hanging off?
I don't know, we just swung over in the van.
RTC male testicles hanging off.
You know this RTC? Are we waking heart up, do you reckon?
Just sending you through a Cat 2 call now for a 39-year-old male. We've actually taken quite a few calls for this.
Paramedics Sam and Mandy, Alpha 097, are the closest crew to the patient. They are 4 minutes away.
39-year-old male, RTC, testicles hanging off. There is blood loss.
That's on a bike, is it?
I don't know. That's the injury you really don't want.
A senior paramedic is also dispatched and is 5 minutes behind.
Right, so I'm presuming it's this slip road up here.
Oh, it's a van.
It's a van that's left the road.
Hi, brother, it's all right. Let's have a look.
What's happened to it?
All right, OK. What's happened? How did you end up crashing over here?
It's clipped the edge out and everything.
OK. What we're going to do, we're going to get you back on the ambulance.
I don't want to be awake.
All right, mate. We'll sort you, all right, mate. We'll sort your pain out, OK? I promise you. We'll look after you.
I'll wake you to sleep.
OK. What's happened is he's been driving up the slip roads. He reckons he's clipped something, spun the van. So it looks like his penis cut up here and his testicles are, like, out. Yeah. Alpha 097. Hi, I'm just wondering if you've got an advanced paramedic in the area that can come and help us with this job. This patient's been involved in an RTC, and he's got very substantial damage to his penis and genital areas. He might need sedating because of advanced pain relief.
Yeah, we'll try and get the 128 AP.
Thank you.
We've set the AP off from MRI. We're just wondering if you've got any further update on injuries or details, and whether the doctor from HeliMed would be of assistance.
We get HeliMed running if you want. They can actually land on the slip road.
Yeah, roger. I'll let them know, and they'll probably get mobilised. They've asked if you'll set off. They can't get to his injuries, but it looks like a serious injury to his testicle and his penis.
We need to put him to sleep. I don't want to be awake.
Get you some pain relief, OK?
Oh, shit, you know.
Right, have you had morphine before?
I don't know.
Right, OK, we'll give you some morphine.
Is it going to have to come off?
No, it won't come off, but you obviously you'll need some surgery, all right?
No, but all right, my dad died that night, and all.
Who died?
My dad.
Did he die in hospital?
Yeah. So he thought we had to look at my little pecker.
I've seen smaller. You've got an helicopter coming.
Fuck off.
No.
Hey, no, don't do all that for me, man.
No. You need it.
Know.
Listen, the helicopter has got a doctor on board. That's the only reason why.
She's looking nice. Right. Becca don't work no more, though.
I'm sure that just wonders what they can do these days. I can hear Ellie Med
now. Tell him not to pop her.
Hey, listen.
Over.
No, you're not.
I don't need all this.
Listen. They're just going to shut that box junction there, and then Ellie Med, they can't land on here, apparently.
Can't park there, mate.
Hello, my name's Gemma, okay, I'm one of the advanced paramedics. The crew are doing really well and they've given you quite a bit of pain relief already. We'll see how you go.
Hiya. Right, we're going to go on lift, yeah? Ready, steady, lift.
Oh, it's good. I'm sorry about this.
All right, there, Sam.
Yeah, yeah. Whoa, hang on. Here we go.
Looking up.
Okay.
I think you've got this wrapped up, to be honest.
Probably all right. We've got another 5 of morphine and cast an air.
Yeah, exactly. You've got another 5 of morphine.
Yeah.
He's pretty settled, isn't he?
Thank you very much.
Can we stop off at the Albion and get a pint on the way?
Better what, Albion?
You better add.
Please. Fucking murder a pint.
Are you happy?
Oh, yeah, happy, thank you.
The patient will be taken to the nearest A&E at Manchester Royal Infirmary.
Keep going on this, but take it every single breath that you breathe in. Like that, keep going. Keep going.
It's all right, you'll be
okay. I can't be in hospital, got me down to town.
Okay.
I'm walking out. All the bad people need your help.
He's over here. Oh, mate, it's what we're here for, supplies.
My bollocks all right.
I think your bollocks are right, actually, yeah, to be fair, from what I saw.
So you can remember the...
He's called
Steve.
I'm
all right, I've just got Steven, no yeah. dick.
OK.
Time is still bigger than his, so...
Oh, it's gone straight to voicemail. So we'll try again in a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds. Are you ready? We're going in.
Right.
You can go on that gas if you need to. It's coming with you.
If you want to go faster.
Alpha 097 just picked up your clear on that previous job. I was just wondering if you had any updates. Sounded like quite a traumatic injury.
Yeah, it was definitely a traumatic injury. So what happened was this gentleman was travelling in the passenger seat of a van, wasn't wearing his seatbelt for whatever reason. The driver lost control of the van, veered off, the van rolled, and he's somehow managed to deglove his penis. Obviously, having rolled in a van with no seatbelt on, he's lucky to be alive. But I'm not sure that luck is really something he's got the past couple of days, to be fair, taking aside this injury that he's got. His dad only died last night.
It's horrible to have to deal with that and then have to deal with something as life-changing as this as well. I can only wish him the best of luck and hope that he's all right with his grief as well. Thank you very much.
Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
No, come into the lounge and he's on the floor. He's cold, is as white as a sheet, and I reckon he's passed away.
It's 9 hours into the shift, and across the service, over 70 patients are waiting for an ambulance.
That's connecting mobile. There's been no speech or request, and I'm unsure if that is someone's breathing problem.
Hello? Can you hear me? Hello? Can you just tap on your phone if you can hear me?
Just put EMA, can hear noisy breathing.
Despite not being able to communicate with the patient,
hello.
The decision is made to allocate the job as a Category 1 call. Difficulty in breathing could indicate an ongoing heart attack.
We've got an emergency ambulance being arranged for you now.
An ambulance is dispatched and is 8 minutes away from the patient.
Hi, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Are you able to tap the phone? Hello?
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 Hi, I'm so sorry, the dog's been sat on the phone.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay.
So an ambulance isn't required?
Is an ambulance not required?
No, it's just been knocking on now.
Okay.
Just put dog was sat on phone whole time.
Ambulance,
is the patient
breathing?
Yeah, he's like having a fit in the street. He's got a seizure, I think.
Has he come out of that seizure now?
He's shaking quite a lot.
We have got that help arranged, and we are coming on lights and sirens as quickly as we can.
196 have been pinged on a one.
Alpha 196, you've been auto-allocated to a 30-year-old male who's currently having a fit out.
No further information at this point. He is still fitting.
As the nearest available crew, Jess and Abby are automatically allocated the call. They are 3 miles away.
Do you know what? I go to a fitter at least once a day.
Oh, we're up.
Lovely.
I'll just see what's happening first.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm Jess, this is Abby.
I was walking behind
him. What's happening? Yeah.
And he just started bending over double. And I just thought he was in pain with his knee or something.
Mm-hmm.
And then he just went right down. And then he started having a seizure. And
OK, let's get you in, hey? Let's get you straight in on the bed. Lovely. How often do they happen?
Recently, like once a month.
It's scary, these things, isn't it?
It's not happening in public.
Is it not? OK, have you been by yourself then? And these guys found you?
Or at work, yeah. Like,
OK.
Well, this is my new job here, but...
OK, what job is it?
I'm a chef.
Oh, yeah. Whereabouts?
Just across the road.
OK. Everything we've done so far is absolutely fine.
Would you be able just to let me go home?
We can do. We can...
Yeah.
When you normally have repeated seizures, does it normally happen once, then straight away the next one?
I've never had a repeated one. Only, like, not Not on the same day?
Yeah, we could take you home, and if anything changes at all, you need to ring us back. So were you coming from work?
I was going to work, so...
Right, I see. That's one way to get out your shift anyway, isn't it?
My old job wasn't very accepting of this.
Really?
I'd call in sick and they'd make it a big issue and all that. And that
it's
just
crazy,
makes it more stressful.
Yeah, definitely. Because then you're made to feel guilty, aren't you, for having something that you genuinely
can't avoid
control.
That's why I left that job. But
good for you, though.
My new chef, he's epileptic, so
more
he sort of understands it, yeah.
You need somebody, don't you, that you can relate to and just understands what you're going through.
Yeah.
Rather than, obviously, a management that don't really care about
staff. Just don't understand
it,
yeah. How long have you been a paramedic for?
Been qualified for a year and a half.
Year and a half, nice.
Yeah, not too long,
nice.
Actually. It's flown by, though. It's
busy. Keeps you busy.
Yeah, it really does. Best way to be, though. You know, it's not only a job for me. I love what I do. If I was to have that taken away from me, whether that's from a disability or a long-term condition, I couldn't imagine it. It must be frightening. There you go. Don't forget your phone. Oh, and your bag.
Take care, Tyler. No worries.
It's all right. Nice to meet you anyway. Take care of yourself. Yeah. Bless him. My mum was a carer for 30 years. She used to work 60 hours a week. I'm paying for things at home at the minute between me and my mum because my mum's had to come out of work. I think it's been really difficult for her. My job is the way me and my mum are able to survive. Alpha 196.
Have you got any further updates on this job?
This guy was having a seizure. He seems to be okay. It seems like a normal seizure for him. So we're happy for him to go home safely.
It's good that we've managed to help him out today and get him back safe and sound.
That was your last job of the day, so if you'd like to head back to base, thank you very much for all your help today, and I hope you have a good evening.
Thanks for looking after us, Jamie.
Thank
you. A lovely evening,
see
and we'll
later.
Speak to you bright and early tomorrow.
Oh, my days.
What are you doing tonight?
Probably going straight to bed when I get home. I'm so tired.
097, that's last job of the day. Thank you so much for all your help today, and I hope you have a good evening.
Good night from us.
Good night. I feel uncomfortable sat down, though.
What?
After seeing that.
Okay. An ambulance is being arranged for him, but you need to answer this question so we know what type of ambulance you're sending, okay? Just fucking hurry up, you bastard. Please do not call me names, okay? I'm not being funny, I'm not being violent, yeah, but like, they just... Don't call me the C-word, please, okay? Help is being arranged for him. Send me a fucking ambulance. I go to work and pay my taxes for like you. Send me a fucking ambulance. Yeah, help has been arranged. We'll be with you as soon as possible. Okay, take care now. Bye.
It's got to take 5 minutes.
There's hope that a dispute between the government and NHS workers could be resolved after health unions largely agreed to recommend the latest pay offer. Ambulance workers have been offered a 5% pay rise from April and a one-off payment over £1,000 to top up last year's pay.
Evening.
It's the start of a new 12-hour shift for the North West Ambulance Service. NHS workers, including paramedics and nurses, are awaiting results of the ballot on whether to accept or reject the government's latest pay offer.
Have you voted for your pay?
I voted yes.
I voted yes.
They've got you by the danglies with that lump sum.
See, I voted no because I would have preferred a better percentage.
I think it's the fact that everybody's struggling to pay the bills because everything's so expensive at the moment.
I've had to take a loan out through winter just so that we could cover the gas bill that month because it was that high.
I didn't join this job to expect an amazing pay packet, but especially with the way things are getting tighter and tighter, I just want to have maybe 50 quid at the end of the month left over in my bank. But we don't have that at the minute.
Do you know what? I went shopping yesterday, did my food shop, as you do. I got 2 bags worth of stuff, and it was probably double the price that it used to be.
It's gone mad. Like, I went in to buy... You know the way they say don't shop when you're hungry?
I always do.
I went to buy 2 things, and I hadn't eaten breakfast at this stage, and I must spend about 40 quid, and I don't actually know what I bought. I couldn't actually tell you what
loads
I bought.
Loads of snacks.
Yeah.
Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
He's breathing. What's happened? He's just been involved in a collision in a car.
Okay, is the patient awake?
He's awake, yeah. Are you okay to speak to the ambulance?
I think he might be.
Hello, it's the ambulance. Have you hurt yourself from this car crash?
I don't think so. I just bit dozed, that's all.
Is there anything in particular that's concerning you?
No, not really, no. Just okay. My car.
Alpha 169, it's starting. I have a job for you if you're ready.
Yeah, we're ready.
Just ARTC, one casualty.
Absolutely no details. All I know is a 65-year-old male, no mention of injuries either.
Paramedic Sam and emergency technician Danny are the closest crew and are 6 minutes away from the patient.
Oh, do you think he was on his way home from work?
I'd imagine so. At 65.
Maybe he's been taking sprees.
Maybe he's on his way out back from the beer garden.
Well, I hope not. Oh, blimey. Where's the front of the car? Oh, God. Hello. Has anyone seen what's happened?
So he's had a collision with these two gents here.
How long ago that?
Where's their car?
Their car just on their drive.
Okay, he's on the phone at the minute.
Yeah, can you hear that?
I'm quite there.
Hello?
What's your name, sorry?
Hi, it's a paramedic here. I think he's a bit worried about his car, but I just need to assess him at the moment.
When are they going to pick it up?
We'll sort that out. Let's just focus on you right now.
We'll get you sorted okay. first, all
and then
right.
we'll sort your car out, I promise you. So what we're probably best off doing is getting you on our ambulance.
Are you single?
Are you asking me out?
Yeah. Right. Were you getting that much today, were you?
I was shopping.
You were right.
I told you, where were you shopping?
Aldi.
Oh, I prefer Aldi too. Other than your blood pressure, your observations are spot on.
Right.
Okay. The car is going to get sorted via the police or the insurance.
So, I've got stuff in the car, so...
We can get that out and we can take you home.
Right.
Yeah.
Who's picking the car up then?
I think the insurance company.
They got much in the car?
Yeah, got bleach and some ham.
I was going to say, what sort of concoction are you making there?
Well, the bleach. The bleach, they put the price up. It was 120, it's 150 now. Everything's gone up. All the prices in the supermarket's ridiculous.
David, what would you like me to get you out of the car?
The bleach and the ham.
Mind your head.
You want the bleach and the ham?
Yeah, it's heavy, you know.
I'm fine. I'm hench. Oh, bless him. He's stockpiling his bleach.
Does it get annoying after a while?
You have the essentials.
We've got the bleach and we've got the ham.
So all the stuff in the boot, they'll ring me, will they?
Yeah. Yeah, but we'll make sure it's locked so it's safe until they collect it, okay?
Right.
An awful lot of bleach here. Are you buying it while it's still cheap?
It's not cheap, it's £1.50. I've missed the European lottery. 76 million it was.
Oh, wouldn't you love to go and set up? What would you do with 76 million?
First thing, he's going to buy a villa in Mallorca.
You can buy yourself a new car if you want it.
I want that car, so. Been doing it 20 years and I've never won.
Oh, David, are you okay?
So they locked it up then?
I've done it. I locked it.
Are they going to pick it up, are they?
Yeah.
Alpha 169.
We have done an assessment on this gentleman. The car took quite a bit of a whack, unfortunately, but luckily this guy's got no injuries. He lives down the road, so we're just going to turn around. We've got his shopping out. He's got about 12 bottles of bleach that he needs to get home. 14, sorry, and some ham.
We're
going to
drop him off at home and
just
make sure we get him safe, if that's OK. Yeah,
Rog, not a
problem.
Ambulance, is the patient breathing?
Yeah, she's breathing. She's a cancer patient. Okay. The temperature's dropped. She was sat upstairs fine, and then all of a sudden she started vomiting. This is the second lot of chemo she's had, and obviously this is absolutely rotten.
Alpha 196, just passing you through a Category 2 call for a 54-year-old female. We've got limited notes because it's initially gone out to a clinician to review and they've upgraded it to a Cat 2. All I've got is that we've got a chemo patient who is vomiting and is unable to get off the floor.
Alpha 196, Jess and Abby are immediately dispatched to the patient.
Patient is shouting in the background and appears to be very distressed at going to hospital. 54, she's the same age as my mum as well.
Oh, Jesus.
Are you okay for this one?
Yeah, I'll be all right.
If at any point it gets too much, just let me know.
I will do.
It's horrible, isn't it? Like, I've got such a pit in my stomach now just reading that. It's just typical, isn't it? Getting a job like this.
Come on,
let's go.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, hello, doggy.
Yes,
hi, dog.
Hiya.
I'm Jess, this is Emily.
How old's your cat? They're very tiny.
She's...
It's on your arm, it's a bit chilly.
She's, five.
She's titch, isn't she?
She's a proper mummy's cat and she misses my hair.
You had long hair.
Yeah, very long hair.
Have you offered you, like, any wigs or anything like that?
Yeah, I've got a brilliant wig, but I can't wear it in the minute because
Is it itching?
It's there still, and it's so sore. My hair was down here.
Was it?
Oh, really?
Wow.
But the best thing about it all is my grandson is six. He's not sort of... He's not judging me, has he?
Kids don't.
He's not bothered about...
Why would he?
I don't know, because some kids, it frightens.
Maybe if they don't understand.
Yeah, it's probably more...
Oh, he understands everything.
He's intrigued more than anything.
Yeah,
she
but
said that Grandma's lost her hair, and he went, wow.
He did. Oh, he looked at me, and I'm going, wow. And I'm not Nana, I'm not Grandma, I'm Grandma. I feel embarrassed and I think, well...
You shouldn't be. I know it's easier for us to say...
People say, embrace it. Mm. I don't want to embrace it. I don't want to embrace cancer.
It's because you don't want to have it.
I don't want to embrace baldness. I don't want my daughter to see me like this.
No, I know. You are bloody strong to get through this. You know, you're on your second round of chemo and you're doing amazing. And speaking to you, you know, it's so... It shouldn't be embarrassed for them.
It's
you're somebody they can look up to now, and you know you're such a strong woman. Gotta make me cry. Don't start me crying.
I just want to see my grandson. I've got them.
Something to fight for.
Stop it, you. You're making me cry.
It's a gold thing.
Oh, God.
I just want to see my grandson's go through high school.
He's going to be so proud of you.
My mum's going through the exact same thing, and I look up to her and I think, gosh, you're such a strong woman. And I would never feel embarrassed about her, ever.
I think you look great.
Never. You do, you look amazing.
So, you're on your second round and you've been vomiting today. And you feel like you picked up a bit of a cold.
Yeah. Going back to work.
Yeah.
As much as I've enjoyed it,
And I think with the insomnia and...
it's been a bit much for you.
It has been a little bit. But it's for my own mental health, and it's long days, and we don't get breaks.
How many hours are you working?
Well, before I was doing 11-hour shifts, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday, but now I'm doing 9-hour shifts Monday.
Even that?
Shifts.
9 hours is way too much, especially somebody that's going through chemo, you know.
Yeah.
You're so brilliant for doing it this week. I can't believe you've done it, but... 4 hours, maybe 4 or 5 hours, and just see how you get on, and don't put the pressure on yourself to perform as like you used to do.
I'm just beforehand.
You need to take it easy.
A stubborn old
cow. I know you are.
Oh, that's better.
I'm happy with the way you are now, but I just want to let the nurses know. Hopefully they don't take too long ringing back.
But
20 minutes or so.
Yeah, no worries.
Okay. It's been lovely to meet you. You're an inspiration, honestly. I'm not just saying that. I think from my point of view, it's quite difficult going to patients, going through the same thing that I've got back at home.
Oh, that was difficult.
Because to me, I'm meeting a stranger and telling them that everything's gonna be okay, when at home, I feel like it's not gonna be okay.
Don't.
Because that stuff.
You okay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 196, go ahead.
Yeah, just thought we'd give you a little update. We have had to ring Christie's and we're keeping her at home. So just need to finish the paperwork and go back her broom, really, and just have a bit of a reset after that job. It was quite a tough one.
Thank you very much for the update on that one. I will make you one available. Just let me know when everything's all sorted.
Keep her flat, kneel by her side, and then put one hand flat in the centre of her chest and put the other hand on top of that, OK? And lock your fingers together.
It's nearly 3 hours into the shift, and across the service, call handlers have received over 500 calls for help.
Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
I don't know. It's my husband.
Are you with him at the moment?
Yeah, he's lying on the bed.
Are you able to just get close enough to see if the patient is currently breathing?
I don't know. He's got no pulse.
So an emergency ambulance is being arranged. We've just got to confirm, is there a defibrillator nearby?
No.
So I'm going to tell you how to give life support. So kneel by his side and put one hand flat in the centre of his chest. Push, 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 push.
We are coming to him on lights and sirens, OK? Keep that going.
Romeo 372, this drive's coming through, 67-year-old male. Found unresponsive, can't wake up, currently not breathing.
Aidan is immediately dispatched. He is 2 minutes away from the patient who is not breathing.
We have got Romeo 330, 1 minute away, and Alpha 352, 8 minutes away.
I'll give you an update when I get on to you. Where are we going, darling? Is it your husband?
No,
hello. What's happened, right? We're going to get him on the floor, OK? Yep.
I couldn't see whether he was breathing or not. I thought he was just asleep.
3, 2, 1, ventilate. Stop motion. Analysing now.
Are you all right? Just try and sneak past us, darling. Is that OK? We'll update you shortly. Is that OK?
If no pulse, start CPR.
Second adrenaline is going in. Hiya, darling. So at the minute, his heart's completely stopped, OK? He's not breathing, and it looks like his heart stopped at some point while he's been in the bedroom. So at the minute, there's resuscitation going on, and we're giving him a lot of medicine to try and respond to get his heart working again, OK? If he responds to treatment and his heart's working again, we'll be going to hospital. If there's no change in his current rhythm, then we'll be stopping resuscitation here. OK. So I'm going to go next door and help my colleagues. If you just support each other, and then I'll come and update you as soon as I know anything. Is that OK?
Yeah.
All right, look after each other. We'll be back shortly. All right, sweet. So we'll give adrenaline number 4 and number 5, OK, and then see where we are within the 30 minutes. If there's no changes to the complex, then I'll have a chat with family. That's pretty much it, to be fair, but I think that's enough. Bless him. So we're going to do one more cycle. We're going to have a chat with family, see if they want to be here when we stop resus. Is that OK? Right. Hello. So we're at that stage in the terms of the resuscitation where his heart's not responded to anything we've done. I am really, really sorry. I'm so sorry. We will be stopping resuscitation shortly. OK, sweet. Now, the question I always ask every family is, would you like to be there when we start resuscitation and hold his hand? Is that OK? So I'll take you in, sweet, OK? Just take your time, all right? I'm with you. So we'll start resuscitation shortly, OK? I am so sorry, lovely. Oh, bless you. I wish the outcome was different, I really do. It's not nice, part of the job.
Thank you.
They're not nice times.
Doing everything that you've done.
You know, that's why we're here, for people like yourself who genuinely need us.
I didn't think I'd have to go to a job like that.
No, so soon.
Literally a week today, I was sat in Christie's for 6 hours crying the whole time.
And we're going through everything.
For God's sake. Stop crying, Jeff.
You have to.
So difficult. I've never cried in front of a patient before. I really didn't want to cry because I didn't want to show her that, you know, like, we're meant to be people that...
I know, but...
that are, like, supportive. God. The fact that I've seen my mum like that when I was little, that was, like, my memories growing up, is my mum looking just like Paula.
All you want to do is make it better, make it go. And fix it, because that's what we do as a job. We fix it.
I first met a paramedic when I was 8. That was the first time she was diagnosed with cancer. My mum hadn't been well for quite a while and I had to call the ambulance. Rang a number and the next minute we've got two paramedics walking through the door. I knew that they helped her and they reassured her. I remember saying to her straight away, I'm going to do that when I'm older. I am going to be that person for somebody else in the future.
Oh, yeah.
Look at the state of my face, Mum.
What have you done to your eye?
I've been crying because I've just been to a 54-year-old woman going through chemo and it's been so difficult.
Oh.
My mascara's down my face and Abby's eyelashes are falling out. If you're taking your temperature, you look really flushed.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to take it when I go upstairs. Just been sick of it. Not a lot like last night, but some.
Have you been taking paracetamol?
Not yet. I'm going to.
Take it, because you look really, really hot.
OK.
I love you.
Love you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. No, I'm all right. I'm fine. It's always been me and my mum, really. She's watched me grow up and become the paramedic I've always wanted to be. I always want to become a better person for myself, but also to make her proud as well. She's definitely my inspiration for everything I do, really.
Blank your neck.
I'm cold.
Brownie and brew time, I think it is.
Oh, yeah. Brownie and a brew. I'm
really proud of you, though.
Thank you. I couldn't have done that with anyone else, I don't think.
Call me up to meet you, static on the phone. Normally I need you this time.
Just trying to make sure you're okay after that last one.
We did work on him in terms of full resuscitation, but, you know, he didn't respond to treatment. So it's quite sad, really, dying in his 60s, bless him.
You just never know what's around the corner, do you?
That's true. You know, they say they make the most while you're here.
You turn up and you do your best, and sometimes your best isn't good enough. And sometimes I have to break devastating news. I try and comfort people at the worst moments of their life. Afterwards, it does sit on your mind. And then before you know it, a next call comes in and you go into another cardiac arrest. It makes me treasure life even more. Despite all the ongoing strikes and the pay disputes, we have to stay positive. Because we are always there for people who need us the most. Lately I've been certain there's no further to go. Oh, yeah, you had the chance to love me, but apparently you won't. No, you won't.
No, BBC you News for Greater Manchester, I'm Al Tamsin. If I could. Unison says it's accepted the offer, which includes a 5% pay rise this
Seriously?
Year.
Seriously?
Record numbers of.
Oh, I'm glad. I'm so glad about that. I've now experienced being like, right, we're really struggling with money now. And I'm like, no, I really need this. Yeah. So I'm glad about that. I'm so happy about that.
Going through life, people have been like, oh, don't do that. I'm sure you could get a lot more money somewhere else. No matter what, this is all I've ever wanted to do. And coming into work, putting the uniform on and being like, God, I'm actually doing this. I'm actually a paramedic now, and I'm going into people's houses and replicating that setup of what it was like for me and my mum all them years ago, and being that person for somebody else and somebody else's kids and family. It's definitely a fulfilling job.
Waiting for it there no more anyway.